Hi, this is Chris Copeland. I'm the head hitchhiker over at Hitchhiker's Guide to Humanity, and I'm also the alien for, or the human for the alien Crystal. And I'm here today with Roni, who is the human for the alien Mako, and my co-host today. And we are talking about corruption in a Kenyan government and African government. And right now, we're going to really dive into how companies affect corruption in Kenyan government. So Roni, go ahead and say hi to our listeners and let's dive into this.
Hi everybody, thank you for tuning in again to this episode. So corruption, companies and how they contribute to corruption. It's just like you mentioned in the previous, in one of the previous episodes, how companies in America are contributing to campaigns of politicians during election time. So it's sort of similar in Kenya as well. I remember when we had our last elections, we had a lot of we had to repeat the elections actually, because the first election was nullified on grounds of cheating and stealing the elections by the party which won. So one of the companies which was accused of helping or aiding this particular political party in stealing the elections and in corruption was Safaricom, the biggest mobile service provider in Kenya. So people started saying that we need to, the opposition now, plus people who support the opposition or who are against the Jubilee winning the elections, were like, we need to boycott Safaricom, we need to boycott Safaricom. But at the end of the day, it is the biggest service provider. So people still ended up just continuing with it. There are also, these politicians also have stake in companies like the current president has a lot of, and the people he has in his political circle, a lot of stake in a lot of companies, Brookside and the likes. So you find that money from these companies and a lot of other big companies are used to contribute to their campaigns or to help them in their campaigns to get into office and things like that. So these are some of the ways that companies contribute to corruption issues. Also find the way I was telling you about on a more individualistic level, a lot of companies nowadays, when you're going to work, when you need to find employment in a company, you need to part with some money in some companies for you to be employed in that company. So the person who's in HR or who is in charge of recruitment will ask you to bribe them, to give them, to buy them some chai for them to push your application forward, or for them to help you get a particular job. So that is some of the ways that these companies that we have in Kenya are also contributing to the corruption issues.
That sounds pretty much identical to what goes on in America. And what they do is kind of like what the politicians there do. They'll basically diversify and find back. So let's say we have, you know, AT&T, we have Sprint, we have US Cellular. They'll actually take contributions from all of them, not just one of them. So if you boycott one of them, I mean, you can't really boycott all of them because you need those services. So I'm thinking that's a similar situation with like Safaricom and the other mobile providers there as well. Now, so this gives me like two examples, and I want to do this fairly because, you know, while I am a socialist Democrat, there are a lot of problems with corruption on both sides of the aisle in America. Here's a perfect example from the Democrat side. Hillary Clinton was one of the first proponents of universal health care in America. While her husband was president, that was her big thing that she really wanted to push as first lady, is universal health care for all. And so she started really making like a big, big stink in Washington about like, why doesn't everybody have equal access to healthcare? Why isn't this just an automatic thing for Americans? And she kind of ended up getting into a lot of trouble with lobbyists over that. till finally they actually convinced her to take money from the insurance companies. And then all of a sudden her big push, her big campaign for universal health care just disappeared. And then she went back to being like the regular first lady who wore the pretty dresses and waved and smiled whenever she went out with Bill. But that's all she did. She wasn't effective anymore. And she was one of the first first ladies in a long time that had been effective in trying to make change. And it was just incredibly disappointing that she sold out like that to these insurance companies so that they could stop this whole nonsense about universal healthcare in America. And yeah, she just kind of quietly went away on it, while other people who strongly believed in it, like Bernie Sanders, continued to fight for it and continue fighting for it to this day. Now, on the other side of the aisle, of course, the biggest example of this would be Trump. And recently, he actually, this is a kind of a funny one. So we've all heard Trump's, racist comments towards Mexicans. He's called them rapists before, he's called them thieves, he's called them murderers. And then of course, some of them are pretty good. That was a literal, like, something he said during his campaign. Well, the head of Goya Foods, who is Hispanic himself, kind of kissed his butt recently, and you know, during a meeting with him, and it was on camera. And he's basically saying that he, you know, really appreciates all that Trump has done and for America, and of course, Latinas and Latinos all across America were outraged to hear someone who is Latino himself say these things to someone who has obviously been racist towards Latinas and Latinos. And so, yeah, he's in big trouble over that. And now there's a boycott going on for Goya food. So no one is going to be eating their beans for a while, I think. That's really going to cause some damage to their company because he's pissed off his biggest consumer of those foods. So Mexican restaurants are not going to be buying that product as much anymore. And you know, Mexican American households and Latino American households are not going to be purchasing that anymore. And, I think that Goya Foods is available here in the Netherlands because I think I've purchased, some of their beans before. I won't be doing that anymore. And I've strongly encouraged all my Dutch friends to no longer purchase those if they've been purchasing, just switch to a different product. It may not be as tasty, but hey, you know what is more important than that? You know, fairness and equality and justice. So, but there's lots of examples of people on both sides of the aisle, you know, taking handouts or receiving gifts from these corrupt companies. Who influence the laws and make sure that the laws benefit them, especially the tax breaks. Like, we have Amazon. Jeff Bezos doesn't pay a cent in taxes. I pay a lot in taxes, but this billionaire doesn't pay anything. There are things like that that are so incredibly unfair in the world that we don't see here in Western Europe. And the reason we don't see it is because taxes are done a lot more vigorously towards the wealthy, as it should be. You know, the those who make less money are still working hard. They're just not getting paid as much. So the way to make that more equitable is to spread the wealth and make sure that everyone has a basic quality of life. That it meets a minimum standard for human beings. And unfortunately, that standard is not met in America at all. And I'm seeing, you know, it's obviously not met in Kenya at all either. So, you know, my hope is that, you know, we continue to, if we see companies doing wrong, if we see companies supporting corrupt politicians, they're boycotted too. We're not going to spend our money with them anymore. And so I strongly encourage people all over the world that if you see there's corruption going on in a company, don't spend your money with that company. There are other options available. Go buy local, you know, buy from Farmer Bob down the road instead. He needs that money more anyway. So yeah, you may be spending a little bit more because Farmer Bob has more overhead and can't cut costs the way a big corporation can, but you're paying a fair price for it and you know it's going to someone good. So yeah, support those small businesses when you can. and try not to support the corrupt ones. So yeah, any final words on that, Roni? Any advice towards your fellow Kenyans and Africans and people all over the world about what they can do to end corruption?
Don't participate and don't normalize bribing people. That is the worst thing that we have been doing and that we can do. It makes these people feel more powerful, the ones who are withholding these services so that they can get a little bit of money from it. You're entitled to those services. So people need to stop this behavior of whenever they want something done, they feel that they need to give money and bribe people and give money and bribe people all over the place. So I think to any African or Kenyan who's listening, this is something that you can do at an individual level. You can just take a stand and say that it is ethically wrong. I will find another alternative of handling something. So if you can find another alternative that does not involve bribery, please take a stand. And it's change starts, of course, with a person. We cannot keep talking about change and there's nothing we are doing about it. If it's a company that is involved in corruption issues, like you said, boycott that company. There are a lot of other companies selling similar products that you can get, or services that offer similar services that you can get. So yeah, it starts with us as the citizens and as the individuals before it even gets up there.
And just for the Westerners that are listening, please buy fair trade, especially African products. If you're looking at coffee, buy fair trade, because the kind of corruption that goes on with coffee, with spice trade, even with porn, is outrageous, because we don't practice fair trade. Know who you're buying from. Know where that money is going. Make sure that you can track back to the farm that you purchased your coffee from, so that you know that no one was harmed along the way, so you could enjoy that morning cup of cappuccino or espresso. Just know where your stuff comes from. That's super key. Yeah. And I want to just restate what Roni said. That statement you said about participate or don't participate, don't normalize. Absolutely. Those are the things we need to do. We need to stop normalizing that it's okay to buy the cheaper brand coffees that we know are going to be practically stolen from farmers. And the participate in the system of corruption. We have alternatives. Go find them. So yeah, make sure you do your research. Don't buy products with mica in them unless you know that mica is made in a lab or that it's properly sourced and so children aren't dying to get it for you. Know where your goods are coming from. Know where your services are coming from. Know who provides you the things that you have. Just exercise your right to spend your money wisely. So yeah, that's an awesome conversation, Roni. I think that's a great thing to end it on. Don't participate, don't normalize. Great statement there, Roni. So thank you guys so much for listening. And if you have any products or brands that you recommend, put them in the comments. We would love to hear what companies we should be supporting. And then if you've heard statements about companies that we shouldn't be supporting, make sure you tell us about that. We don't know unless someone tells us. Please do that. One company I've always recommend is if you're into beauty products or perfumes is Lush. I know that all of their stuff is fair trade and it's all fairly sourced. And it provides excellent funds to good causes all over the world. So I definitely support Lush. That was introduced to me by a friend of mine that lives in the same apartment building as me. So yeah, that would be my good company for the day. Roni, do you have any particular brands, especially, you know, coming out of Africa, do you have any coffees that you recommend or teas or anything else that is sold from Kenya and going into other parts of the world?
Yeah, there are a lot of tea brands that I think like Ketepa and such that I think are being exported into other countries. I will get you a list of coffee brands which you can buy, but the people who are local, these companies which have been tied to corruption like the Brookside and such, which are also tied to people who are corrupt, and these big hotels that belong to these corrupt politicians. Those are the places that we don't necessarily need to get into, because there are other hotels that are equally good, that you can get the service that you need from. There are a lot of other companies that sell milk. You can buy milk from a company that is not those companies that are tied to the big corrupt politicians that we have.
That sounds great. Thank you so much for that advice, Roni. And remember to share in the comments what you like to participate in and what brands you recommend. So yeah, just that final statement, don't participate, don't normalize corruption. And thank you guys so much for listening. And thank you, Roni, for joining us today. We will see you in our next episode.
Bye.